We commonly come across this issue when we're putting through, when we do fundraisers and things like that. We normally have one campaign or one cause that we're raising money for, so be it Syria or whatever it is. And sometimes donors add on their own cause. So I just wanted to get your perspective on, I know of course we should always honor the donor's true intention, but if there is a real like need, emergency need for one cause and someone's saying, no, I want my money to go somewhere else, how would you prioritize?
Okay. First of all, try as much as you can not to be driven by the donor. This was happening in a lot of organizations in different countries, and they are responding to the donor's wish. I give you the example of Syria. When I sit down with Syria organization, startup 2-3 years ago, and they tell me that this organization giving us projects that we do not want to implement because their donor wants it. They want the money from the donor. So they entertain the donor, don't give them the money for this project, but in my area, I cannot do this one. But I have to do it because I need the money. So they let the people to do a project what they don't need. Educate the donor, even if you lose the fund. Our experience in Islamic Leaf, when 15 years ago at least, the Minister of Endowment in Qatar gave us $1 million to build a school in Albania. Okay? Because we told them we need to build a school there, to make a school. For 1 year, Islamic Leaf failed to buy the land because the registry has to be in the name of a local, not of Islamic Leaf as INGO. After 1 year, we failed to buy a piece of land to build the school. So I asked Harun, which is the chief of my finance and manager at that time, to give me the check back, and they went to the minister. Tell them, sir, this is your money. He said, what? Nobody gave us the money back. After 1 year, I said, I failed to buy the land. This is your money back. So I told the donor at the time, I could have fooled him. It's haram. Will he be able to discover? Maybe after 10 years or 20 years, he'll discover, oh, it's not bought by the name of Islamic. But this is not the right way. Be honest with the donor. Softly, softly with the donor, and educate the donor to the point that I don't want your money. Sorry, sir. If you can entertain his donation, if his donation is sizable, and allow you to do a new project with the capacity of your office in the field and your office follow up, this is a different story. But if each donor comes and tell you, I want you here and there, I said, sorry, cannot do it, go somewhere else. This will earn you more respect. You might lose one or two donors, or five or 10 donors, but you may, they actually have the success story. I heard this story about us returning back the check to the minister in Qatar from a CEO of Qatar Charity this year. The minister, who is not a minister anymore, still saying what you as Islamic, not you as Hanan Banna, but what Islamic Leaf gave him the money 15 years ago because he could not be able to buy the piece. He says about a story which never happened to him when he was a minister in the government. Everybody take the money and buy high. Tell the donor. You have donor care when you get the money, but you have to have donor education before you get the money.